The 69 Ford Mustang was cool, no doubt about it. But was it aerodynamic too, or was it just all show and no substance? To find out, we did an aerodynamic simulation of it. It's cruising at 45 miles per hour, and this plane shows that its wake is actually pretty small. But because of the lip at the back of the trunk, several vortices form, which isn't great for drag. On the other hand, the diffuser works very well, directing the flow up and making sure the flow stays attached back here, which helps reduce the drag. The front air dam-like structure also creates a big wake, so that increases the drag in this region. But I'm a little surprised that over the back window, with all these jagged slats, the flow isn't too troubled by them. The front window is a little too upright though, which results in a lot of flow crashing into it and increasing the drag. The flow accelerates over the top of the roof, which increases the lift of the car, which isn't desirable, which is why the lift coefficient comes in at 0.075. This plane is a bird's eye view cutting just over the trunk. The wake is on the larger side and extends about one car length downstream. If we move a little lower, this plane shows that the rear styling of the car was probably the least aerodynamic feature because we do get a lot of vortices here, as well as a very wide wake. Both of these things increase the drag. But one positive note is that the rear is sharp, which makes the wake more stable and that helps compensate this drag increase. This video shows that all of these massive vortex structures occur not just in the wake but really all over the car. So this car has a lot more vortex drag than a regular car, even at the time. So what does this drag coefficient come out to be, and how does it compare to the 59 Eldorado we tested a few weeks ago? Let's find out. It's just 0.57, which is much better than the Cadillac. But in terms of coolness, I would actually flip this order and rate the Caddy higher, like this. What do you think? Peace out, amigos.